So the weather's coming in, but just to quickly explain what a strombolian cone or a cinder cone is made of, it's made of this very well sorted airfall. So these, you can see, lapilli sized bits of scoria that have built up, raining out of the sky as airfall, very angular, very well sorted. And you have alternating layers of this, and then finer grained ash, and then blocks and bombs that were raining down. And these deposits basically built up and up and up to form the flanks of this volcano that we're on. Behind me, you can see the lava flows. So this material is not very strong, you can imagine. Layers of this built up, and at some point during this eruption, there was a failure of the flank of the volcano, and that opened up an area where the lava flow could leak out. And that's where you can see the lava flow leaked out. So initially you built up the cone, a side of the cone failed, and lava basically bulldozed that cone and started advancing towards the town beneath us. So here I am up on top of Eldheimar. Spectacular views and a great way to learn about what is the rocks that make up this top of the scoria cone. You can see this red scoria in front of me. It's very different to the black loose stuff that I was throwing in the air down below. It's still well sorted, it's still an airfall deposit, it's still very angular, but you can see it's stuck together, it's agglutinated back together to forming more competent and solid layers of scoria. And in amongst the scoria, there are spatter bombs, so liquid bombs that landed on top like cowpats, building up the summit of the volcano. And it's this material that eventually failed during the eruption. You can imagine a slow collapse of the flank of the volcano down towards the town. And it was this slow collapse as it was being bulldozed by lava behind. And this bulldozing of lava basically pushed out these rafts of cone towards the town as the RR sheets advanced in lobes and fanning out towards the town below.